Jeff.
Yeah.
We're going to do Westcoast Ramble.
We are.
That's right. Look at, we're doing
on camera and
we're
everything.
Doing it on camera.
I hope I don't burp or swear or anything.
And Brandon, let me see. Where's my camera? Oh, my friend Big Sam. Got all my troubles. Hey, man, you guys can be talking about one big thing. He's got something to say about my baby left me. Which is not a good thing.
No.
But anyways, he's an expert on it because he's got a lot of bands.
About losing.
And Jeff, you're an expert on some things too, aren't you?
Well, it's been known to happen.
How many gigs did you lose?
Well, actually, I think a couple coming up. But I'm not in the same boat that
a cup full.
You guys, like I used to be. And that was the first thing I thought of in recent days of our rapidly changing world here.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I lost two gigs. You know, and with our band, in fact, I just lost another one for April. So that was bad for me. Everyone say hello to our good friend, Big Sandy. Say hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hi, Big Sandy.
Hello. Yeah, good to see you guys.
Hi, Tom.
It's us up in here in the studio.
Hi, Jeff.
And Robert, how many gigs have you lost?
Well, it's uncertain at the moment because the cancellations are sort of open-ended.
Yeah.
We're not sure what... we could be losing a lot. We're everything that's been on the books now is sort of in question. There's definitely everything within the next month and a half is gone. Beyond that, I don't know.
Yeah, yeah. So,
but also I have other I do other side things from time to time. DJ gigs, had a couple of things, some other shows with some other musician friends that have all fallen by the wayside. As of yesterday, some as of today. It's the sort of thing where each, at first it was like every day brought new bad news. Now every hour.
Yeah.
It's changing as we speak.
Okay. Okay, great. Hey,
let me just say real fast, I'm glad the last show I went to was you guys at Original Mics. I had a really great time all day.
Well, I'm glad you're able to be there.
And then, but I was even a week ago not thinking that way. You know,
that
like
was
that
so
would be, you know.
Sunday.
I know, that was eight days ago. Yeah.
No, not even, is it in that? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was 8 days, yeah. Yeah, but anyway, that was, I had a ball.
We had just,
it was
on
great.
That day. We had just gotten off of tour. The word of the virus was kind of bubbling under as we were on the tour. It was kind of vague. You'd hear
it seemed distant. Yeah,
but even by that day, it didn't seem like anything that was
right.
Well, I knew it was something to be concerned about, but I didn't know how it was going to affect us. But each day since that, since last Sunday, has been
rapidly.
Oh, It's been pretty nuts.
Yeah.
For everybody, of course.
Yeah.
But,
yeah. Well, okay, let me see. We started to get a couple comments here, which is cool about this show is we can comment. And Lloyd Buttfoy told me to turn up my mic.
Okay.
So I really want to talk louder until I could get over there and turn up my mic.
Not Lloyd, Tom's mic or my mic? Or
no, it's mine. It says, Tom, turn up your mic.
Okay.
No, you guys sound great.
We got the condenser, sir.
Yeah. Oh, let me try this. All this stuff here. We got Rudy Ramos says hello from SoCal. You know Rudy Ramos?
I do know Rudy Ramos. Hey, yeah. Rudy Ramos.
Yeah, man. Hey, thanks, Rudy Ramos. Anyway, yeah. So another thing, friends. Let me see. If you're watching this, you can go ahead and make your comments, and then put your comments on, and we can put them up here and read. So it's pretty interactive. That's what our goal is, to try to talk to you guys, and ask questions to Robert or even Jeff. Jeff's got things to say. He's a knowledgeable guy.
I do.
Jeff,
you say that as like that would be something hard to difficult to believe.
Yeah, I
of
know.
Of course he does.
Or like I'm gone already or something.
Cheers.
Yeah. No, we all loved Jeff, you know. Okay. Oh, so
varying degrees.
They
of
all
course.
Do. Who's we?
The royal we.
Yeah, the royal we.
I just took the royal we.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, take it easy. Okay, so Lloyd, I am going to turn up my mic and I'm going to walk over there, but in the meantime, we kind of had an idea of What would we do for bands? Like, let's say there's going to be no more gigs where you can't get people out there. So I was thinking, like, if we had bands in this show, like in this room in the West Coast Ramble Studios, and then we could, you know, people could watch them online. It's an interactive thing, you know what I mean?
Yes.
And, you know, maybe get people to tip a few bucks to these guys, because, you know, if you're in a band.
Not tonight, mind you.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah.
With the way
well,
things.
Well, a lot of people have been talking about that sort of thing, and I think there's going to be a lot of artists of all sorts doing that sort of thing. A lot of people in different fields doing that.
Rent parties.
The music world is something I know, and certainly a lot of bands and musicians talking about putting together something like that. So it would be.
Yeah.
I think, and I think if there's any silver lining out of this horrible situation, I really think that there will be some good things that come out of this. You know, out of adversity often springs innovation.
That's how Velcro was created, because the moon lit missions, you know.
Okay, well, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I remember going way back. I remember when there was one fellow walking on the street eating a chocolate bar.
Yeah.
He didn't know right around the corner there was a fellow walking down the street eating a jar of peanut butter. And they bumped into each other in the Reese's peanut butter cup.
It just goes to show you. Yeah.
Yeah, Robert, your 1970 television commercials are showing now. Okay, hey, look, we got some comments here. friends, take a look at our friend Alex from Riverside.
Oh, is Artie?
Yeah. He says, hey, guys, let's get the Moondogs back to Riverside.
Oh, boy.
What do you mean, oh, boy?
Talk about a broken record. No. Not that I wouldn't want to get the Moondogs back together, and I would like to do that. But he's been hounding me about the Moondogs for a while.
Yeah. Well, I you know, and so has my friend Kenny, the drummer from the Moondogs.
We love
to
Kenny.
Play.
Yeah,
he wanted to play too. You know,
well, I love Alex too. Don't get
Robert. Not all of us get to have gigs all the time and have fun all the time. You know, like you're the one who gets to have all the fun all the time.
Oh, well, there's the other side of it as well. We were just talking before we went live.
There, before air time.
There's another side that's difficult?
Don't make me show that on the camera.
Well,
not on live podcasting or whatever this is.
Okay, now look.
I almost said TV.
Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to turn up the mic. And, Jeff, did you not get some letters or not?
Oh, okay.
You know what? No matter what happens, they keep writing in.
Okay, we'll go ahead and say your letters, and never mind the fact that there might be a dude walking behind Jeff real quick. Go ahead, Jeff.
Oh, who might that be?
This is my favorite part of the show, by the way, guys.
Okay, this is sort of seasonal. It's going to be, no matter what's going on, it's still St. Patrick's Day tomorrow, and I'm observing that. This is from D.T. O'Reilly from Plaster City, Wisconsin. I work in a distillery as a field tester. In my spare time, I like to drink and listen to West Coast Ramble. It's funnier that way. So I got to get back to practicing drinking for St. Patrick's Day. Well, now there's a man after my own liver.
With a razor.
Yeah. Okay, this next one. Now, I like this because I'm getting into this territory age-wise. But
okay.
This is from Del Elder of Dale Scott, Arizona. I have an oldies band with some other senior citizens. We call ourselves the Fuddy Daddies. Average age is about 80. I sing and play rhythm guitar with Artie Ritus on lead, Early to Bed Ed on bass, and our girl drummer, Sophie Security. We're all fans of West Coast Ramble, and we have an album out called Rhythm and Rheumatism. It's all your favorite oldies done slower. We're going on a tour with some other acts like us called Legends of Leisure World. So keep the show coming. That's a nice letter.
Yeah.
I like that.
These are actual letters,
yeah,
by
these
the way.
Are actual letters.
Yeah, actual letters written by somebody.
People can still write.
Did you get these in the mail? Like
I did. In your mailbox? Yeah. Like written, like I do still. Yeah. Like right. Dell, like Dell did.
Yeah.
Okay, this is an interesting one. And I'm hoping they're still in business given the recent times. But I'll just, It's from a restaurant. This is from Ronald Red Grisler of Red's Raw Burger, El Monte, California. That's right over the hill from me. Wanted to say everybody here at Red's Raw Burger loves West Coast Ramble. And I wanted to plug our restaurant. Well, he's honest anyhow. We serve meat, red meat, like it was meant to be. Freshly butchered, bleeding, and succeeding. Here's the Red's Raw Burger jingle.
Okay, I'm ready.
Where did I put it? There it is. Our buns are pink. Our buns are wet. A raw deal you'll never get. If the skin's ripped off and the heart's quit beating, Red's Raw Burger is what you're eating. That's pretty... It makes me want to go there.
Hold on a second.
Bring the kids. We got raw veal, too. And don't forget our Sunday Bloody Sunday brunch with real Bloody Marys. With six or more, you get extra Ebola sauce for free.
Oh, too soon. Too soon.
Okay.
Too soon?
Yeah, why are you getting outside disease time? Hold on a second.
Wait a second. I'd say road trip, but they might have to close for a while.
There's no voting on this.
Wait a second.
All right, keep going.
Okay, for a raw deal, try Red's. Just a bloody good burger. Red's Raw Burger, the heart attackiest place on earth. I wonder what their side orders are like. Well, anyway, given our current situation, I would say that'd be a good road trip because it's in El Monte and that's...
Yeah, it's not
it's
too far.
It's near us. You know.
Yeah, helping the local people.
Makes me want to go.
Yeah.
I like a pink and wet bun.
Who doesn't? All right. Thank you, Jeff. Look at I got like crowd noise and all sorts of stuff with this system. It's exciting. This is like real TV.
We just lost 9 viewers.
Oh, okay. Who called that in?
Well, I had 8 to begin with.
Okay. Oh, look. We got some other people. Celine Lee from...
Oh, Celine Lee.
She says, hey from Memphis.
How you doing, Celine? Well, I was just out, the band, the Fly Right Boys and myself were just out in Memphis at the Ameripolitan Awards.
Yeah.
Celine Lee did a fantastic job. Happy birthday, by the way. She just had her birthday a couple of days ago.
Was that Celine Lee? She was the gal that did it with you? She did she was the co-host with you?
She's the one... who controls the strings. Dale Watson is the puppet, and she's the one who's...
And you said
she makes it all happen.
Oh, really?
Well, together they make it. They
she
made
pulls
a
the strings.
Whole event with a bunch of other great people working along with them.
Yeah. Hey, since I got you here, what happened with the Ameripolitan Awards? I mean, I've never been to it. It's a Nashville deal, and a lot of people show up to this thing.
It's a
Nashville, isn't it?
No, it's Memphis.
Memphis. Memphis. Okay.
Memphis, but it's artists from around the world who don't focus on artists who wouldn't normally get mainstream attention.
Yeah.
In the country field, western swing, rockabilly, honky tonk.
Yeah.
There's different categories, and I think it's a really important thing that they're doing. But also, it's just like a hell of a good time. But
yeah,
it's a pretty good hang.
I was, I was looking at the Facebook. There we go. Sorry, I was looking at the Facebook post, and there was a lot of people like, "Hey, man, I'm at what is that called? Sun Studios."
Yeah.
And everyone is taking all these tours and Beale Street and whatnot. So yeah, I should have known it was in Memphis.
Well, Memphis is obviously an amazing place. I said it a few times out there. It's sort of like our Mecca.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
If you're into the sort of music that we are,
yeah.
But I think the city and that region could use a little help, and I think this is the shot in the arm that it needs. And I think the Ameripolitan team working together with the city is creating a wonderful thing.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, like, I've done a little bit of traveling for business because I'm a traveling shoe salesman, but I've been to Memphis a bunch of times.
Is that what you've been doing?
Yes, that's what I've been doing. And I
can't. Why are you wearing those?
No, anyway, and I noticed like there's a lot of music going on there, but really like the best musicians to me, and forgive me, but they're in Nashville. Like all the best, you know, whether you like that type of music or not, but the best pickers are there and the best singers are there. And it seems like everyone's going to Nashville. Is that true, Robert, or am I just making that up?
Well, I think now there are more musicians in Nashville that are kind of doing the sort of stuff I like, more than there was for a long time.
Yeah.
But that's just because these are young, you know, like cool friends of mine that have kind of migrated that way. A few of them are originally from that area. But I think there's a lot of, there's a certain generation that's rediscovering the roots of a lot of the music that we grew up loving.
Yeah.
Even in my world, a lot of us grew up listening to rockabilly. A lot of, as you get a little bit older, you kind of reach a little bit farther back. Where did that come from? What led to that? Yeah. And to some of the young people, they know it all. And there's some great, great pickers and singers and that are coming up. And, you know, each generation, gets better and better. Maybe not on the mainstream, but it's those who aren't in the mainstream that organization focuses on.
More to draw from.
Yeah.
Too.
Well,
if that makes sense.
That does make sense. In fact, we got a note here from a guy from Nashville who just moved there. His name is Anthony Castagna.
Oh, yeah, we love old Anthony there.
Yeah, and he says, hey, from Nashville.
Hey, Anthony, how you doing, buddy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm glad Anthony's watching this thing. I figured he would, you know. And I got something to say about Anthony. I love his picking, but he's like one of the best dressed dudes. Like when he plays, I'm like, oh.
Did he buy shoes from you?
Yeah, no. Anyways, I don't know where that guy gets his style from, but I'm really impressed with such a young
from
dude.
Ashley.
Did he? What? Did he really?
The house of Ashley.
Really? Really? He just went over to Ashley Kingman's place and go.
Just messing around.
Oh, okay. I didn't know. I didn't know Ashley was known.
Hi,
for...
Hi, Ashley. Yeah, by the way.
I didn't know Ashley was known for his fashion.
Well, he's like. There are certain pictures where he looks like, well, you're going for an Ashley look there.
Oh, really? Oh. Well, that's
well,
not
well, a... well, he's joked about it himself, too. So
oh, Anthony has? Yeah.
Anything out of school.
Anyway, yeah, well, I like the fact that there's young folks. Oh, wait, and there's just to let you know, there's some other people. Tracy Dick says...
Tracy!
Yeah. Hey from Hastings.
Hey from Hastings.
Yeah.
That's a song.
Tracy never let go.
Isn't there a song? Oh.
Yeah,
that's another one.
So anyway, that's kind of cool. Well, where's Tracy Dick from? Hastings, is that, excuse me, man.
She's lived in a few different places. I got to know her when she was living up in the Bay Area. But she's been in the UK for a while. She was living in Texas and in the Austin area, and now she's back over there now. She's back overseas now.
Oh, cool. Well, anyway, as we were just talking about Anthony Castagna, he just...
What are you doing up, Tracy?
Better than being down.
Yeah, Anthony says, I learned everything from Ash, my biological father.
What? See?
What does that mean?
Is he liable?
Does he owe you money now?
He has a kid and stuff.
And you're going to have to take care of you're going to have to take care of Ash as he gets older? Is that what the deal is,
no.
Anthony? Oh, okay.
Ash can take care of himself.
Okay.
Yes, he can.
All right. I don't know Ash that well. I've talked to him a couple times.
He hates you.
Does he?
Yeah, he told us to tell you that.
Yeah, why, as Jeff would say, I'm sure.
Anyways. So
a little funnier.
Okay, so what else? You know, here's...
I thought this was going to be a serious show.
Yeah, let's get
I'm
serious
glad
about
it's
this.
Not so far.
Tracy Dick says she's watching you. Well, good.
I always feel like.
Yeah. Anyways. So, hey, now, Robert, it looks like you've got a record there.
Yes, I do.
I would like you to talk about
a fine
that,
record, that per- by the way.
It's a 45 record.
It sounds great.
Yeah. And it's styled in the
right
in the way of the 50s.
Yeah. Always like on the TV shows where, like, am I getting the
glare? Hold on, let me see.
Right.
Yeah, hold it steady. Hold it down. Yeah, hold it down. Go like this down a little bit.
Down.
Tilt it. Yeah. Up a little bit.
Why don't I just take it out of the damn sleeve?
Yeah.
Cut the glare factor out.
There we go. What yes, it's a double 45. It's a Big Sandy and the Fly Right
that
Boy
makes
sing
it
and play the music of the songs of Freddie Fender.
Yeah,
it's a little tribute to a guy who meant a lot to me growing up, and it's a kind of striking a certain nerve with a lot of people. We've been selling a lot of them, and if I can say a little bit more than that, I've been working on this something. We did ourselves, and the first project of my own, kind of put a lot of heart and soul into it.
Yeah.
And to see it like sell, like every one that sells is like, oh, it's like it really, it's kind of a nice feeling.
Yeah.
So this has all been happening. We sold a lot of them on the tour, And then by the end of the tour, the coronavirus situation started to happen. But now that, you know, it looks like we're going to be home for a little bit, and a lot of our shows are being shut down. All of our shows are being shut down.
Yeah.
This has sort of been an inspiration for me. It's like, wait a minute, let me work on more things like this. First of all, by getting more of these pressed, getting a CD version of it out there, and making sure downloads of the music are available. Yeah. We've been so busy out on the road, we haven't had time to focus on that. Now I'm home, I'm going to focus on that.
Yeah.
I feel kind of inspired. I'll have a little time to work on things like this, and also write new material. When the time is right, get the guys back together, get back in the studio.
Yeah.
And we've been so busy over the last, several years that the pace that we put out new material has slowed down a little
bit.
I want to get back to putting out things, even if it's just an EP here, a single here.
Yeah.
That thing sounds great. I was playing it with other 45s and the signal is loud, and it just sounds good.
Thanks, Jeff. I'm really happy with it. And just touches my heart, the response that we've been getting to it. It just kind of been inspired me, and it's kind of carrying me through these kind of troubled times right now.
Yeah, you know, that reminds me of we got a thing here from Buck Johnson. He says,
a man from Austin.
He says, Robert's optimism is wonderful and well needed right now.
Oh, thanks, Buck. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Buck.
That means a lot to me.
Yeah.
Buck is a dear friend, and his wife, Brittany, is one of my best friends in the world. They're a wonderful couple, and I wish them all the best. And
I want to say hi to them, too. Yeah. I haven't seen them in a long time.
Well, they've been inspiring to me in ways that they might not even know. And, you know, when we hang out, we don't talk about things like this, like, man, what you've done to me and meant to me. I hope they know the love that's there. Just to see them both succeed in their fields and become adults, because we used to be just when we were younger people. I don't know.
Yeah.
Fun was more of a thing, and they got serious before some of the rest of us. And it was inspiring to see them, you know, get a house and just get farther in their jobs, for Brittany to start her own company, and now a new company where she's doing really well with her t-shirts, with her cowboy daddy t-shirts.
Oh, really?
And
we need to hey,
just like a lot of my other friends, it's like in the music world, there's a lot of fun and games to be had, but at some point you have to have at least one leg in the real world?
That might be another sponsor. We're going to need a sponsor for doing this thing like a TV show now.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's not like it's sidetracked.
Yeah. Oh, don't get sidetracked with sponsors?
I haven't seen them in a long time.
Yeah. Hey, well, talking about sponsors, if anyone has any idea, you want to sell your shirts, you want to sell your... If you redo transmissions,
that Red's Raw Burger might be a good one.
If
they open the restaurants back up.
That's true. Well, I don't know. We'll have to look into that. Anyways, no, but we would look for a sponsor. You know what I want to do is I want to have TK's wife Jill sponsor our show. She said she'd give us a deal on a couple of her shirts, Those are the best shirts ever, man.
That's another couple that's been inspirational.
Yeah,
TK and Jill, what they've done. Yeah,
yeah,
and their businesses.
Yeah, and And friends, if you haven't gone to West Coast Ramble before, check out the last podcast we did. This is the first one we're doing with the video, but the last one we did was just audio only. And we went to TK's ranch, and he played music for us with his band. And if you're into guitar, he's just...
He's not to be missed.
Yeah, he's one of my favorite pickers.
Episode 44.
Yeah. So, anyways, that turned out pretty good. Please go back to West Coast Ramble and check that out. It's pretty good. Anyways, let's see. What else is going on? Hey, Robert, John Patricia Williams says, hey, Uncle Robbie, it's Bella.
Oh, Bella, my niece.
Yeah.
Hi, Bella. Does she have anything to say? Just hey?
Yeah, just hey. They're just saying
hi. Is it hey or hey?
That's so current sounding.
Yeah, I don't know the answer to that. See, you can learn new things, Robert. It's not. You don't have to be all vintage on everything.
Well, that's sounds like part of my family is watching. That's cool. Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, yeah.
How are you doing, the Williams family?
If anyway, your mom's watching, tell her she's got some avocados coming.
She's not.
Oh, okay.
So, okay, friends. Now here's
watching her, one of her programs.
Here's the part of the show. Let's talk about the future. Okay. Now you're talking about things we can do in the future with music and whatnot. And what I really want to do with this studio is I want to have bands in here. You know, I want to do like, you know, ranch party. But I don't have money for a big old set and stuff like that. But what I'd like to do is get, you know, get a good picker in here. Bass player, maybe Pope Paul said he would do it. Get a drummer in here, maybe my friend Kevin or anyone. There's plenty of good drummers around here. Anyways, three piece, then get singers to come in here and rotate, do a couple songs each one, couple gals, couple dudes, you know, play some music. That's what I'd like to do.
Like a little variety.
I think it's a good idea.
Yeah, yeah.
Situation.
I'm with you, Tom. I'm with you.
So basically, so if anyone knows, I talked to Amber Fox. She said she'd be interested in doing it.
All right.
And let's see. Who else could we get? Probably Abby. I'm sure Abby. I talked to her about doing it. She's always great.
Is somebody watching out there or listening out there?
Yeah.
Would like to be part of your future adventures.
Yeah, yeah.
Come ramble with us.
Yeah, come ramble. So, friends, I've just okay. Here's the deal. This is kind of technically hard to do all this stuff, but I'm working it out. And so, like, we're going to start with just the talking.
And we're live. There, don't forget. Yeah. So
and then from
bear
there,
with us.
And then from there, we're going to go to the big old, all the music stuff. But until then, you get to talk to Robert. Hey, look at Mike Stand from the Altar Billies.
Mike Stand.
Now, what does Mike have to say?
Is his brother named Boom?
No.
He says, howdy from Mike Stand. Keep on rocking, brother. You are an inspiration to us ramblin' rockers.
Well,
hey, man, I appreciate that, Michael. That's another good picker. We had those guys on the show years ago. We should have them back sometime. Maybe we don't have to do, like, just singers. Maybe we could have a guitar fest and have, like, I want to have guys, like cut heads. Guitar player
go against. That would be a barber show, wouldn't it?
You're saying that, if you don't mind me just saying what I'm thinking, it's like I'm looking forward to getting kind of back to...
Yeah,
a little bit of normalcy, a place where we can, where you're able to do things like that freely. Like, yeah. I have friends on way opposite ends of the spectrum. Some are thinking like, you know what, nothing's going to stop me. I'm going to get out there and do my thing.
Yeah.
And the other side is like, no, I'm going to isolate myself. I'm not even going to leave the house at all, even for a moment. And I can understand both sides because myself, I don't know what to think. I don't know what to believe.
Yeah.
We've never been through anything like this before. And I think we need to remember that. This is all new to us.
Yeah.
I mean, and people, we're adapting to it at different rates. And what I don't like is I see people jumping on other people for the way that they're responding to it. Oh. That really, really bothers me, man. We're figuring this all out together.
Yeah.
Man, just be show love and compassion and kindness to each other. And,
yeah, which is not what I saw in Walmart the other day.
what's that?
Oh, no, that was my first savage-like experience of all this. And it sort of snuck up on me. Yeah. I just went out to do some regular shopping last Thursday. Yeah. And I kind of distanced myself. I didn't really... It really hit.
You think people were like turning on each other?
It was kind of ugly out there. Yeah. The checker was friendly because I made some joke going to go on because I had some Guinness in my stuff, and I said, "No, that's the most important thing." You know, she was light, but it was not humanity in its best light.
Well, this is reminded me what a delicate
fabric
that weaves our society together. And one little part phrase, and then another part. You can see how close we are to it at all falling apart. So far, everything's been staying together. I've had a different experience. I went to go out to get some just some supplies for my mother today, and I called my father to see. I checked in with my dad to see what he needed, and there was just a regular our local supermarket was just it was just nuts. I mean, I'm not saying anything that. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. We're all experiencing that. It was just crazy. I just went to get a few, some not even toilet paper, just you know, some apples and it was the first time I actually got to use the line of an old, ancient song and really mean it. Yeah, yes, we have no banana. Some lady was looking for that, and she didn't know what I meant. I thought it was being funny. Yes, we have no banana. She's like, huh? Because the bananas were gone, which is a good thing. People buy bananas. Yeah. But anyway, the people in the line, the super long line to check out, and people were being really very sweet to each other.
Good.
There were some other older people coming up and look at the line. They said, no, just come on up to the front. And everybody was talking and engaging with each other, which I've never experienced.
It's got to go that way. It's got to be that way to like get through it.
So I think there's been some positive things in this. Good. That was my experience.
I'm glad
today.
To hear that.
Yeah.
Because my mom's 90. And like she went out to the store by herself yesterday. And don't even go on the weekend. Yeah. They're going to be, you know, and like, I wish she wouldn't have done that, but.
Yeah. Hey, look, we got, let's see. Dorothy Parker said, well, first off, we were talking about that. Ray Chorizo Flores says, we all need to pay attention to that message. Preach, Big Sandy.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
I think I understand every reaction to this. Every reaction I can understand a little bit. Some I don't agree with. That doesn't matter. You know, I'm not that person. I don't know what they're going through. Just remember, we're all trying to figure this out together and try to be understanding. Even if you think this, you know, some people think, you know what, I'm still going to do my shows. I don't care. I'm just going to go out and do it. Nobody's going to. I'm not going to go into too much detail on.
Yeah.
To explain that, but you know, there are people who are kind of saying, no, you can't stop us from doing this. And I can understand that.
Yeah.
Completely. But even if you don't agree with the person who's doing that, don't jump on that person. Don't be vicious. Don't be mean. Don't resort to calling names. I've seen some awful, like, that's the other side of it. I have also seen the negative.
Yeah, because I was being light out there.
Yeah.
I was, you know, trying to be that way.
Yeah, let's just figure this out together. We're going to come out on the good side. And I know for a fact some good things are going to come out of this. For me, they will. Not by magic. Not just because thinking positive is going to make some magic things happen. Just for me personally, thinking positive, I just work better under that atmosphere, with that frame of mind. And I've been on a kind of a positive roll even before this happened, and I want to stay with that.
Yeah. Good.
I'm not trying to be profound.
That's fine. It makes a lot of sense because, like, You kind of see things from a bigger vantage point than the rest of us, you know. I don't know, maybe from your travels or whatever, but that makes a lot of sense, you know. And hey, in fact, so Dorothy Parker wrote this. My 88-year-old mother said she's never seen anything like it either, and she's been through the polio scare, the Great Depression. So thank you so much for this lovely bit of uplifting caring.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah.
Well, bless her.
More of that. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you know, like that's like when we're doing this, when we're doing this show too. I was thinking, you know, should we get all political and figure stuff out? Like, you know, what do we know?
We never have been. We never have been. So we're entertainment here at the end of the day, right?
I mean, I have my
hopefully
know, or suspicions, or I think I, you know,
yeah.
But what do we really know?
Nah.
But you know what? Find the common ground, get through it together.
Yeah.
And then we can get back to arguing with each other.
and all the pettiness and the good stuff.
Well, the thing I like is like all, you know, when you go to a gig, like nowadays, I like to go there because you don't like what friends you're going to see there.
Right.
You know, it's a social thing. And
like
and
your thing. I saw like 25, 30 people. Yeah. I'm so glad I went.
Although I think, I don't know. I just have a feeling that thing, well, obviously things are changing for now.
Yeah.
But there might be more of this sort of thing coming our way. And we need to figure out a new way to, I do music, I need to find a new way to get it out to people.
Yeah.
And that'll be the new normal, you know. I hate stupid little catchphrases like that.
But never say die.
But with
the music.
I'm not even saying that. We just need to adjust and that. That'll be the way things are for the next, you know.
Yeah.
Well, people used to sell records and be all, well, what happened with records? And then was Napster and like, we don't like Napster anymore. And then, you know, now people are SoundCloud or whatever they use, you know, I don't know what they use. But and now like 45s are coming back. It's always changing, but people still always need music and people still want to get out of town and see stuff, you know. And
yeah.
And there's I'm so glad there's still still a need for live music. I mean, I just,
no,
I
there
love,
always will know, be.
Yeah, I mean that's all deals. I just love seeing a good band and like a really good guitar player going off, and you know, and it's such a surprise to see that kind of thing. And you can only do that when you go to a gig. Like,
yeah.
You know, if you go on TV and you watch some band, you're all, you can. It's kind of predictable. Okay, they're going to be okay. But when you find those hidden gems and you're all, God, where did this guy learn to pick like that? Like being a guitar player, I love that. Or you go and you see this band of young dudes and they're like knocking it out of the park. You know, that's what I love.
Or even old dudes knocking it out of the park.
Or, who would that be, you, Jeff?
Guilty. Yeah. Hopefully I'm knocking out.
Hey, Jeff. Oh, go ahead, Robert.
You know, I'm a musician, I'm a singer, I'm a band. So I look at it a lot from that perspective, but I'm also a fan of music, and I can't wait to get back to going to see the local bands. To me, there's nothing like that magic. You know, I can watch it online, and I can get pulled in, and that's great, and I think there's going to be more and more of that. There's nothing like being in the room where something is happening, a chemistry between somebody on stage and people in the audience, and I love when I'm one of those people in the audience, and there's nothing like it.
Yeah.
Well, there's one thing.
Well,
it's a family show.
Okay, all right. I wasn't sure. Yeah. Well, anyways, let's see. Oh, hey, look at Ray Chorizo Flores says, build it and they will come. I think he's talking about our West Coast Ramble concert series.
Oh.
There we go. What do you think about that, Jeff?
I always thought it was a good idea, but I'm glad to hear somebody
and also
give voice to that.
Just like so, like I said earlier, like so many other bands and artists, you know, I'll be doing hopefully together with you and figuring out my own way to get our music out to other people in times where we can't be in the same room together.
Yeah,
there's an opportunity there. What a magical, a different kind of magic, but magical nonetheless to perform live and know that people around the world are watching and listening. So that's something I'd like to explore more.
Well, friends, I'm going to be totally honest with you. We built this studio and the purpose I built this studio and the purpose is because I wanted to have good players come in here so I could kind of have rub elbows with some guys.
Yeah.
So we've had
That's all we're supposed to do now.
Yeah, oh, that's right. We're Nice work, Jeff. That's why you're here. But no, Kid Ramos came in, you know, Tommy Harkenreiter, you know, and like some good pickers come in here, and I love it. And, you know, Mike Stan, that guy was amazing too when he came out. I didn't know the guy was that good, you know, and so, Abby was saying when I was talking about cutting heads, like having some guys come in here and cut heads, she's all Al Martinez. And I've seen Al Martinez a bunch of times, and that guy's a great picker, like totally understated, you know, he's just mellow, but he rips. And so that's what I'm looking forward to. I'd like to get some guys in here and like maybe a guest guitarist every time. And for me, it's like a free concert thing, you know, and I get to record it and I get to like sit back and you don't know, but like I listen to this stuff. Like when we did his thing, I sit back and I listen to that and I like trying to pick out some of his stuff. And like if you're a picker, that's what you do. You know, you thrive on those like cool little notes that the guy does, you know, so. I don't know. To me, it's selfish. That's what I want to do. I want to like have all these guys come to my house and play. Just make sure that they're clean and sanitary.
So, every time I hear that, are you getting messages there, or is that
I'm getting messages. What did you want to hear all the messages? Okay,
well,
hold on.
Check to see if I get any. I'd like to read them on air. I don't know.
Okay, hold on. I'd post this, but it's a pretty thing. Brittany Bell Johnson says, and I've got. Let me see, Brittany. Let me put my. There we go, Brittany. Bell Johnson says, hopefully through this trying time, our musicians' friends can find ways to financially creative, pay live streams or cash donations for new, previously unreleased material. Robert, what do you think about that?
I'm all for it.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
I've been thinking along those lines. We were talking earlier.
Yeah.
But yes, Brittany Bell Johnson.
Yeah. So I think that's probably what we're going to try to do is try to figure some way to monetize this. I mean, you can go ahead and people pay money to watch people play video games, you know, and there's easy ways to do it. Like there's tipping apps and stuff on these shows. But it'd be great, like for these musicians. I mean, some of these guys don't even, you know, they live on the road. What do you do when the road's gone?
Yeah.
You know? So if we can do something like that, that'd be cool. Let's see go ahead.
Well, I think for now I need to find a way to get my band and myself through this little patch here.
Yeah.
But when I said that some good might come out of this, I think it just made time to maybe think a little bit more, be a little bit more productive, think a little more creatively.
Yeah.
And keep that thought and feeling when things are, you know, somewhat back to normal.
Yeah.
That's what I've been thinking.
Sooner the better.
Yeah. Here's another one came in from a guy named Quinn Christopher Millard.
Ah.
Who is that guy?
I used to play with Quinn Millard. Yeah.
Well, so did I. Anyway, so Quinn.
What do you have to say?
Quinn says, I'm
what does it feel like to be normal? Is that what he asks?
Wait, what was that again? Look at man. I know Quinn. He doesn't know what it's like to be normal, and I love it. I love the fact that Quinn is like the quirkiest dude. Great artist, you know, and such a positive guy. I love Quinn. Thanks for watching. This says, Quinn says, I'm going to put it up there. I'm digging your show, Tom. Hey, Robert, Tom, and Jeff from Quinn.
Well, I'll tell you, after you kicked me out of my first band, Quinn was my, Kenny and you guys, Quinn was the next drummer that I had. So
yeah.
Good to hear from you, Quinn.
The mighty Quinn.
Yeah. He was in the Grave Diggers at the time, back then in In the 1980s, you should.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Robert, I did want to say that I never kicked you out of the band. What are you talking about? I never saw
this. We're not going to get into that again, are we?
Old show.
I don't even know what's. Oh, wait, hold on. Here's another thing from Axel.
Again. Play Kalija.
He says, there's nothing like requesting Kalija.
Did he say that?
A big Sandy show.
Oh, see?
You won the luggage again.
Yeah, why don't you play that song again? There we go. So he got you. Yeah, Robert, you called that one. So let's see what else we got. Oh, wait. Oh, Ray Chorizo Flores is back. The Under the Bubble series. What is that? Explain yourself.
He's given a name to what the sort of thing that.
Because we have to be in under the bubble because of this soul.
Under the dome.
Yeah.
Ah, that's a good idea. Yeah. No, maybe so. All right. Well, we'll think about that.
Is there more to this show that you guys do?
We'll take a stand and put it under the dome.
Okay. Hey, you know what I need to do?
Can we talk about snakes?
Well, look, I need to change the battery in my wide camera. So at this point, Jeff, you're going to tell about your trip to the supermarket. Go.
Oh, okay. A few of them.
Oh, there's another supermarket.
Oh, well, on the same, Thursday and Friday, I went out, and that's when I realized, you know, everything had really hit, sort of. And ironically, I actually was down to about one roll of toilet paper.
Yeah.
No kidding aside. And I'd heard all this stuff, but hadn't seen it in action. And so, actually, what I went out to look for, I went into Big Lots. Yeah. And I bought a thing of potting soil.
Yeah.
But the line was clear to the back of the building.
Yeah.
And so all I showed, I waited in this big long line, and all I had
was a
pot. Yeah, and he goes, and the checker even joked about it. He says, "What? No, like, you know, paper towels or anything?" and I go, "No, I'm going to go home and grow food."
Yeah.
Which I'm going to need, you know, because it'll be my 39th garden this year. Yeah. I've done that many times.
Wow.
So and you know, with all this going on, it's even more timely to probably do something like that.
And for those people who don't know, you've always been good. You've always had quite the green thumb.
Green thumbs. Green shirts.
Your own food.
Green. Anyway. But that happened the other day.
Yeah.
All in right. My travels.
So Big Lots was a.
It was, and then I was able to go in a bargain market in the same, this is in Uptown Whittier, in the same thing, because I checked to see if they had a couple things, because I didn't have to repark. And that's where I was, we were talking earlier about an attitude, and I was being jovial and up, and, you know, and watching people freak out, and I was sort of chuckling and being friendly to people, and I go, my, you know, I don't want to go here, you know.
Yeah.
And not trying to add to or get bogged down in it. Because I can get depressed, as you know, about that. Everyone thinks I'm this funny, jovial guy.
You're really depressed.
Well, not depressed no, but I got that side. I Mr. Up and Down kind of. And so I was really not trying to. And I even called Tom about 2 hours before we did this show.
Yeah.
Because things were, let's face it, have been changing rapidly.
Yeah.
I mean, so I just did that to check. But it's all turned out. This is good.
Yes,
this has cheered me up talking about it.
You know, I'll check my my news updates when we finish this, but there's a new decree,
I know.
And
imagine bars being closed on St. Patrick's Day. The unthinkable.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Hey, I got the wide camera going. Hey, let's go over some. You know, we've only got another 15 minutes of our show. But
we haven't taken any calls.
Well, no one called. Like,
well, you didn't give out the number.
I'm not giving out my number.
I'll give out my number.
Yeah. Well, it's two. I'm two.
714.
Oh my gosh, dude.
504-0036.
You want people to call you?
Ask for Lisa.
No. Thing's gonna light up.
Okay, hold on a second. Here we go. Let's say, Chris Wendorf says, "Hey, Big Sandy, aloha from Maui. You're fine, fine, super fine."
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
That's nice. Hey,
yeah.
Hey, Chris. I used to have a crush on Chris when I was in high school. Chris Olson.
Oh, really?
But this Chris might be a fella.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. It's
Kate. Which is fine, but
yeah,
a stubborn kind of fella.
Yeah, I don't know.
Trying to bring roots music back.
You know
in
what?
Here.
I've been to most of the states in the union.
Yeah.
Never to Hawaii though.
What?
Not. I haven't been to Hawaii. Haven't been to Alaska.
What?
I never been to Alaska. Yeah. Hawaii once.
Then okay. Then Chris Wendorf, you need to go ahead and book a gig somewhere for Big Sandy. Fly on over there, and
can you help us with that, Chris?
Yeah. Get him out
I'm
there.
Reaching out to you, Chris.
Yeah, on your do the South Pacific tour.
When I was still a fly right, that was in the cards at one time. They were
there
was going to be
that came
yeah,
up
yeah.
And then it fell through. Yeah.
Okay, and then we got hey, Quinn says, such great times playing music with you guys in the '80s, '50s.
In the '80s, '50s.
Which is kind of true, you know. '80s, '50s, you know. Anyways, you know, it's cool. and Zap Babbitt says, you know what, Zap Babbitt? That's a cool name.
Thanks.
When will there be a new album or of new material? Is he talking to me or is he talking
to...
I think he's talking to you, Robert.
Oh.
Jeff's always
got...
Jeff, probably next week.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Jeff's always got
new. Directed
I'm working on him.
At me.
Yeah.
I'm working on a lot of different things. But I would be really happy if we... walk away from this current CV situation with me having written an album worth of new material. I don't think we'd be able to record it within the next...
I'd be glad for that, too.
Few weeks, but I would say that this thing that is happening now is going to speed up the process of us having an entire new album. Thank you for asking about that.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, hey, back to Chris Wendorf. I'm on vacation. She's from Wisconsin.
Yeah.
And
in the summer. She knows,
you know her on Facebook. I'm a girl.
Oh, okay.
So Chris Wendorf, she's on vacation in Hawaii, so she
Chris.
Can't help you in Hawaii.
Tom, we hardly knew ye.
Yeah. So Chris, you know, that's great that She just can't help you get a gig in Hawaii. But she'll probably come see you again when you go to Wisconsin again, which is nice.
How did I mix those two things?
Chris Wendorf?
No, I was thinking Hawaii.
Wisconsin?
Because she's on vacation in Hawaii. She's from Wisconsin.
I see. How are things over there in Hawaii right now? Are just as nuts as here? I wonder.
Is she even going to get back?
I don't know if they've had cases
there. I think
things
are the same all over, right? Things are tough all over.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
I don't know if those isolated states have had
one call.
Well, I don't know who's going to call you. Hey, Hugh Scott, Hey, Angel's son. Hi, Jeff.
Hi.
Hey, we're talking to Hugh Scott, Russell yeah. Scott's father.
Yeah.
How you doing,
I
Hugh?
Saw him Sunday too. Yeah. Yeah.
And
he just said hi, Jeff.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, buddy.
No. Yeah. He doesn't care.
Well, I said hi to him earlier today.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Nice guy. Yeah, I've seen him before dancing with Angie Angel. Oh, hey, Chris says she wrote back. There we go. Awesome. Coming home Thursday. So she's actually going to make it home
from
Hawaii.
All right. Well, safe travels to you, Chris.
There we go.
And everybody
yeah, we'll
travel.
See you in Wisconsin. Well, we have Wisconsin in the books. I hope, you know, and I'm sure we'll get back to our regular schedule soon.
Yeah.
Hopefully sooner than later.
So let's see. Oh, and one last thing. Matthew Lomer.
Oh, that son of
a. Ah, Matt.
Says, that's my buddy.
He says,
Matt.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I know, okay. What does that mean?
Actually, I know what it means. I know exactly what it means.
Okay.
This goes, Matt and Giselle, this goes out to baby Ben, who
baby
I
Ben.
Was so, oh my good Lord. I was so lucky to spend the last few days with their brand new baby. Three and a half months old now, I guess. They are living in Fresno. They're from down here, Southern California, living in Fresno, about to move back down here to Southern California.
Oh, good.
I went up to hang out with them for a little bit. I had a chance to hang out with their little baby while they were you know, getting some work done.
Yeah.
Just keeping an eye on him and spending some precious time with him. So this goes out to baby Ben. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it. And maybe later, when you're a little older, you know where that came. I'll tell you where that came from.
I'm glad they're moving back down. I didn't know that.
I'm very happy about that as well.
Yeah. We'll have to have some more record hops.
Yeah. Okay, well, cool. Let's see. Oh, let's see. What else is going on? Oh, Dave Valdez says live music will never die.
Yeah.
It might. No.
No.
Well, what's he going to do with the Beatnik Bandito then? They always have the...
How you doing, Dave Valdez?
I was just on texting with him today.
Oh, really?
Because that gig, that was our next thing that got postponed.
They postponed the Beatnik Bandito?
The 26th, and then you know probably our gig on the 5th in Whittier is probably... I haven't heard about that one.
You can't fit 50 people in the Beatnik Bandito and they
Well, I was thinking because of the proximity, that was likely.
Yeah.
Because you're on little folding chairs, you know.
Yeah. Oh, well. Okay, friends.
I think a lot of people are just stepping away from
it. Yeah, laying low for a while.
Well, now the new mandate is 10.
I know.
And we're not.
I know. We're not even practicing that.
We're 6 feet apart now.
Well,
and we don't even have masks either.
I think
my real face, folks.
No, I think if I could like make some kind of spray area where everyone is like conditioned or tested before they come in here. You know, and then we can go ahead and have our concerts. Just have to make sure that everyone is clean. I don't know how you do it. You know, get tested or something like
it
that?
It sounds like an area for male cats to hang out in or something.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. We got
to
do something.
That's to you, Woody, watching at home.
Yeah. So anyways, what I would like to do, man, if you have an idea what bands or people you'd like to see in here, if you know them, let them know that we're looking for them. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to schedule something here. We're going to have a band in here. Talk Tommy into coming here for free.
No, it'll be fun.
Talk Paul into coming here for free. You know, maybe we can put the tip jar out and get some people to tip and put some money in some of these musicians' hands.
Well,
help them out. Yeah.
I
think so.
I guess we're almost done here.
Yeah.
I'd like to hear what some of our friends who just go out to see to hear live music. You know what their thoughts are. But I guess I thought we could interact more with them.
Well, oh, okay. Well,
this is our debut, so
yeah.
I think those things hopefully will develop.
Yeah. No, I just question out there if anyone. We got another 10 minutes, so let us know if you have any ideas of like what bands.
I just wonder if there's any ideas out there.
Yeah.
What would you like to see from bands?
Yeah, bring them on.
Just some of my friends. They're super super passionate and. They're always there to support live music.
Well, what I really...
I just know there are A lot of people are talking about a lot of different ideas, but I know there are thoughts that we haven't even, that I haven't thought of and that haven't been really
touched on yet. Here's what I really like to do. Like I said, I want to get a three-piece band in here that can fit in here, and I want to get a couple singers just to knock off a couple songs. And that way you get a smattering, you know? You get a good vocal dude.
I'm going to take my message. Sorry to interrupt.
No, and that's fine. And, like, maybe you would do a duet or something like that. Different things that you can't really do on stage, you know, but you can get together. You know, Jeff, you could do Money Tree or, you know, one of those old songs you used to do or something.
I'll do it.
Yeah, it's been a while. And that's fun.
I'll do it. I do that in the Wentwoods, too, but when we have...
Yeah, and I think it's fun to do it with, like, with a guest band, too. You don't know what it's going to sound a little different.
No, I would
be
totally up for being a guest singer on there.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, you got the chops.
If the folks can stand me.
No, I love you. Let's see. Okay. Yes. Oh, hey. Go ahead.
Nothing. Just reading. This would be a good time to buy an album from your favorite musicians, or maybe just put one on and dance with your sweetheart. I like that idea. I like that idea.
That's always nice. A good thing to do.
Yeah. Oh, hey. Wanted to say this too. Matthew Larmer. Is it Lerner or how do you
Larmer.
Say? Larmer. Okay. Matthew Larmer says Benny loved it.
Benny, right. You know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see. I wish I could remember the song. There's a Benjamin song. All right, Alex Vargas times 2.
Okay.
Hey, Alex Vargas. I don't know what that means. It's Alex Vargas times 2.
Okay.
That's a nice comment.
Look at Dave Valdez says this. Perhaps with an in-studio audience, like at the Beatnik. But you just said you can't do stuff over there. What's going on? Yes, Robert. You had your hand raised.
If he would be open to doing that, I think that would be ideal. Like a little...
The right kind of... like small audience, small studio audience kind of thing.
Yeah. Well, it's just...
The energy isn't good in there.
Well, I want to say thanks a lot, Dave, because it's really hard to bring all this stuff all over the place, and now you're going to make it all hard to get all this stuff over to your... place, Dave. Thanks a lot. No, I'm just joking. I love Dave.
Well, you have some room here. You could have a few.
Yeah. I don't know, dude. There's not enough oxygen in here.
We could get some little people here. Or
Okay.
Baby Ben.
We could give them the air.
Well, I'm just being. Plus, I'm being selfish because I want to see all these great musicians come into my place and sign my wall, and you know, is that being selfish of me?
No,
maybe it is. Anyways. We got a lot of comments coming in here. Stand by for comments. Abby said that was a great idea from Dave. Abby, you're so...
Actually...
Abby's positive, man. What? Go ahead. Why are you laughing?
Ahead.
You're going to say something.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Okay, hey, how about this one? Anthony Castagna, like lasagna. We did 2 gigs with the virtual tip jar Saturday and Sunday, and people were so great and tipped from all over around the U.S.
I'd be curious about that.
If you build up a following or get enough people to watch, you can make some tips to help pay your... it's a question.
That makes me feel good.
Well, I'll tell you.
Can you pay your bills with it?
Well, if I can comment on that.
Please go ahead, Mr. Sandy.
I've seen people do that sort of thing before, and I thought, oh, my God, how can... anybody do something like I'd never do any, and then the world changed.
Yeah,
and now we have to think about things like that. Yeah. And now maybe that's something to consider. I'd like to hear from more people who have tried that and see what sort of response they've received. And thank you for that, Anthony.
That's actually good. That's good information to know what's going on. And I assume that's the way it is. I mean. You know, because if you get one audience, let's say you're in Anaheim, you're going to get, the 200 people that are in that area. But if you're on Sunday night, you might get people from all over the world. Like right now, we got people all over watching this, and they can really, get a piece of it. Go ahead.
Well, actually.
Yes, Rob.
Actually, this is a good idea.
Okay, what is it? We're waiting.
Alex. Yes. Alex Vargas and his son would like to come in and do a set. And actually, little Alex is fantastic.
The Vargas brothers?
Yeah. No, they do a little thing themselves, mm-hmm.
Father and son.
It just says, Robert, my dad and I will come in and do a set. This is little Alex.
Ooh.
That would be fantastic.
Yeah.
And I think that would be inspirational to some of the younger people out there.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Sounds like a guest.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. Have them contact me. Let's get the ball rolling.
You heard
on this
that
thing.
There. Drop me a line later, and I'll send you Tom's information to get in touch with him.
Well, we got a couple other things going on. Quinn says XTC sense is working overtime. When you said
he's got it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah.
Yeah.
You nailed it, Quinn.
I know. Quinn.
But baby Ben doesn't know that.
Yeah.
Yet.
Yes. Sandra Smith says, I'm going to read a couple more and then we got to go.
Okay.
But it says, I watched a live cast of Lydia Britton from Nashville last night. They had a Venmo account to tip. It was a good time.
Okay.
So it does work.
Was it live at a club or like in a studio? If you have time to write back, even if it's after we're off the air, let me know that. I'm curious about that.
Yeah, that's interesting. Okay, Mike Stand again says, Lloyd, you and Spence are the best, always there with a smile, and Spence. We love the Spence on that bass. So, man, maybe we get some Spence up here. Talking about young Spence on the bass.
You got to think about all the young talent that's coming up. Yeah.
Well, then let's do it. You know, I'll work out this venue, guys. I got nothing to do because the job I was working on just came in on Thursday, and they said, hey, guess what? We don't have a TV show to shoot anymore.
So you kind of got laid off.
But I'm shooting tomorrow at the place where they doesn't matter. Well, it does matter. You know where they do the Batmobile and all that stuff? They make all the Rat Fink stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm working with those guys tomorrow. That'll be like the last job I have for like 3 months.
Okay, so see, you're not a musician, but you you're having to refigure what you're going to be doing going forward, just like so many other people are. We can all figure out our thing. Let's see what we can all come up with. I bet there's going to be some cool things that come out of this.
Yeah, yeah.
That's kind of what I was alluding to earlier.
Yeah, we have to. Hey, wait. I got a thing from Tommy Harkin Ryder.
Ah,
I wonder what that guy does.
We lost a gig tomorrow. No, what's today? Monday? Yeah, we were supposed to do a gig together on Wednesday.
Oh,
we
Tommy?
Lost that.
Oh, dig it. So it says, hey, Tommy says, let's give it a shot this weekend since we got a canceled gig this week. Like you're just
Tommy, I'm down, man. He wants to do a little tequila party, jam session thing going on and stream that live. I'm in.
Yeah, yeah.
Since not only did my Wednesday gig fall out, my show this weekend fell out as well.
Okay.
Let's do it, Tommy.
Yeah. Hey, hold on a second. We got a couple more things that we need to hear from. And Abby's jumping in there. Let's see.
Wow.
Bill Nelson says, we will really learn to appreciate our favorite artists during this time. We should also get very creative right now without our usual distractions.
Okay.
That's Bill Nelson.
See, that's a good attitude. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to hear things like that.
Yeah. Hey, and Abby came up with this, and she's right about this. She says, let's do it. Some other people in there. For example, McKinley James is doing that this Wednesday at 7 p.m. So I assume he's doing a live webcast thing at 7 p.m.
Yeah.
McKinley James, who I'd love to have in here. Another young picker who's just awesome. Oh, and regarding Tommy, Harkinrider says, I'll buy the tequila.
Oh, I'm in all the way.
Oh, and Sandra Smith, he was talking about it was lightly attended. Black Rabbit gig for Lydia.
Oh, okay.
So that's something. Oh, and one last person. Gosh, Anthony, what did you say? Oh, here we go. Anthony says, I played on that show. It was at a club, but it was closed, and the staff came in and was our studio audience.
Oh, so.
But it could be done from anywhere.
That sounds cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think we're on the right. I think
we'll
we're on the
come
right
out
deal.
Of this. Yeah.
Well, I think rather than just say, you know, this sucks, or just
yeah, I've
hiding
never
yourself
had
away,
that. Yeah.
Or going the opposite. There are things that we
yeah,
can all
you,
do.
You have to look. You have to look at them.
Let's see.
Up
let's see. What's, yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what other artists do. Of all artists of all kinds.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, and hey.
Magicians.
Ray Treso Flores.
Don't pull
says,
it out of the hat.
You guys announce, and we will push. That's what
there we go. We
Ray Chorizo
says. We need more like you, my man. And congratulations on your new beautiful, beautiful fly ride girl.
All right, man. So that's about it. Let's see. Let's close down this show. You got any parting comments? You got any gigs coming up, Jeff?
Well, I did. I told you the ones we did. But I'm going to part it with a toast to St. Patty's Day with my Jeff West flask.
All right.
That Joe Tatter gave me a long time ago.
Yeah, hold it up to that camera. That's the one there. Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
It's got... Wow.
Is that a pewter?
It smells terrible.
No, not a pewter.
No.
Right.
Happy period. Yeah. I'm going to leave it at that.
Well, I think we should all celebrate each other. Let's get through this thing together.
Let's have happy.
That sounds like a good idea. Yeah.
All right, guys. Very well. Then
I'm sticking to it.
I want to thank our sponsors of the show. We had, it was Tennessee Ernie Ford sponsored the show on this side.
The Clancy Brothers for St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah, Clancy Brothers on the other side. And
Waldemar Records.
Yeah. Buy that, folks.
An unpaid promotion.
It's excellent.
All right, guys. So, hey, thanks a lot to everyone who commented in here. And we're going to do another one. When should we do another one? Robert, do you think we do one this weekend? I don't know.
That's
we got to work
you.
It out.
This is y'all's thing.
Yeah. Well,
Maybe I'd pop in again.
Yeah. Well, if we're going to be doing the music, I expect you to be here, Robert, if you don't mind. I'd love that.
Are you going to? You think you might do it as quickly as this weekend?
And send those letters
let me see
in.
What Tommy has in lettuce. Yeah. Lettuce.
Let us be.
All right. Okay. And we got a couple people. Linda Ochoa says, "Little Alex Vargas, thank you for a great show."
That's awesome.
Anthony says, "Let's do it weekly." And Abby is clapping her hands.
Do it weekly.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. You know, that's for medicinal purposes. Matthew Lomer says, "Live from Janison with Jameson tomorrow at Jeff's." Cheers, all. Hey.
You should do a remote from your place, Pat.
I like that.
Yeah.
It's been known to happen over there.
Okay. And Quinn says, post and let's know when the next show is, please. So, of course,
yeah,
Quinn.
Good idea. Thanks, yeah. Quinn.
And Quinn will come in here and give Big Sandy a free tattoo. That's what we're going to do. Thanks, Quinn, for you're going to give him a tattoo.
In
right?
public.
Live. We can live stream that, right?
Well, yeah, live stream live Quinn giving yes. a tattoo. I drew a picture of my wife, and I thought maybe you could put it on my chest. It's a really good picture. I'm a good artist. Anyways, that's a joke.
I thought this was family.
Okay,
if you have to explain this, something is a joke.
Yeah, it's gone.
Okay, so it's no more jokes. Copy that. Okay, so that was it for West Coast Ramble. Let me put up our logo and our music and stand by. We're almost out of here. I got to do this properly, guys. And thank you so much for coming on over here. Where's our music? Oh, here
Eat
it is.
Some corned beef if you can get it.
Yeah, you got it.
Be kind.
Be kind, everybody.
Be kind to corned beef.
Friends, we'll see you next time on West Coast Ramble. We'll let you know. Watch to find out when we're going to be going out with our next show. We're going to work on it. We'll let you know.
Bye, everybody.